is up, guys? Stephanie Sequeira here, aka the Ab Chick and Super Blackstone Labs athlete. We are here at Iron University with Aldo, aka Iron University, and we are going through an amazing leg workout. This is going to be focused on.
Well, we're going to hit everything today because we already focused on glutes the other day, so we're just going to bash out like a bunch of different angles for the legs, back of the legs, front of the legs, everything.
So for those who do not know, Aldo has been training me since I believe April, and I've been seeing amazing gains everywhere despite being at a deficit. So yes, you guys can put on muscle while losing weight.
Sure.
So you just need to know how to train. And a person, if you're here down in South Florida, highly recommend him to come and check him out and really learn stuff. The basics of training and just even more advanced techniques from there. So we're gonna get started on the workout. He already started without me because I was 2 minutes late. So let's get this. So today we're gonna have, tell me when you're ready, sorry. So today we're gonna have two beautiful ladies helping us out with our workout. Aldo usually trains me, but he has interns that come in and help him out. You wanna introduce them?
Yeah, sure, this is Dom. And then that is Camille. They're both interns, are learning everything that they can while they're here. They're gonna spot us today because since I'm gonna be training, I'm gonna be very winded and exhausted myself, so I'm not gonna try to be working out both times when I'm resting and while I'm working out, so they're gonna go ahead and spot me. There's an art of spotting, and I taught them as much as I can, so you'll see their technique when they spot me and spot Stephanie, so we'll get started. We're gonna start off with lion hamstring curls. Stephanie's going up first. This is her warm-up weight, 45 pounds on the lion leg row. One. Just get 12 to 15 in.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So right now I am training for my next show, and it's in 4 weeks. I literally just stepped off stage last weekend, and I'm already ready to go with my next goals, and it includes just getting bigger glutes and shredding down that area. So we're gonna start increasing that cardio back up, lowering down those calories, and keep on hammering it. Key is though, we want to make sure that we are still lifting heavy throughout like the whole time that you are on prep, because you don't want to make, you want to make sure you're using the muscle you've worked so hard for. And I feel like that's like the biggest mistake that I see with people that are on prep. They literally go and get the lightest weights or don't try to keep up with the same weight that they've done in the past. So, key tips.
Come on. Go. 7. One more. Drive it up. Keep going. Squeeze. Squeeze it. Fuck it. 2 more. Go. Up. Come on. Squeeze. Control the negative. 1 more. Up. Squeeze. All the way. Use that contraction and control all the way down.
9, 8.
Good.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. There you go. Am I doing the same way?
Yeah, you do that.
Oh my god. What Aldo really taught me how to do was really take my breaks, rest, let that muscle recover, and then go on to my next set. Like that, it allows you to go heavier and to really push that weight, and it doesn't become a cardio session, and it's more of a lifting session, and that's how I've been really able to maintain and grow my muscle. It's too late. Come on. Squeeze. Come on!
Six.
Squeeze! Come on, squeeze! Squeeze!
Don't yell at me.
No, you look at me.
Good.
We have a new intern.
Hi.
That's Dom. That's Stephanie.
Hi, I'm Natalia.
That's Josh, the next one over there.
She's running.
Oh yeah. And then Josh is one of our other trainers here. He's amazing.
Hello, I'm Josh.
And then yeah, so they have some really badass chicks in here training people. So just because we're girls doesn't mean we don't know what we're doing or that we don't know how to lift heavy or whatever else. So just putting that out there.
It's all you. Pull it up. All the way up.
Yeah.
Go. Pull. Pull.
Control it. Come on.
Three, let's go, that's four. Go.
Come on.
Pull it up.
Squeeze at the top, come on.
Nice.
Come on, all the way. Squeeze. Control it all the way down. Good, that's it. Good. Leg extensions. I'm gonna start with 70 pounds. I'm gonna go for like 20 to 30 reps, depending on how I feel. I got fucked up old man knees, so see how I feel. And then second set, I'll go a little heavier. And then probably do one or two more sets after that, heavy as you can, past failure, and then we'll go into a compound movement, like either the hack squat, bedroom squat, or leg press. See, I'm not kicking it up. I'm contracting through motion. Flexing my quads at the top, and I'm using that contraction to control on the way down instead of just releasing and dropping it, what usually people mostly do. So I'm just contracting through the motion, flexing at the top, using that contraction to control it on the negative. Then contract. And as you get better and better, you can move it around more confidently. So the cues I give them, what I picked up from Ben Campo from the MI40 gym, is you're gripping your grip on the handles as tight as you can, pulling your ass into the pad as hard as you can, and then you're pushing your hamstrings through the pad. I like to tell them to sink their hamstrings into the pad, and as they do that, naturally your legs are going to come up. And as they come up, I tell them to contract their muscles as hard as they can. And at the top of the motion, I tell them to dig their toes into their hips. And then on the way down, I want them to use that contraction to control it on the negative.
My guy for 15?
Two, yeah. I mean, there's a place and time for that, but we save that for the final set. As we progress, we get heavier. And then once we can't do it anymore with the technical way, I call this the technical way because it's the most taxing and hardest way of doing it. Once you hit failure to that, then you can start doing it the normal way, like everybody else does it. And that way you train beyond past failure, you can hit like 5 to 10 more reps of using the other method of training that people usually do. So I'm feeling a little better on my knees, so I'm gonna go a little bit heavier, a little bit more explosive.
Keep on putting on the weight.
Yeah.
So that's what we do here. We just progressively increase the weight. Yeah.
Harder and harder.
Make it harder and harder. Don't settle, guys. Do not settle. Just keep going heavier and harder. And that's how you make gains.
See my position? I get stuck in there as much as I can. People usually just sit in here, let the knees flare out, and they just start fucking kicking. The most important thing is your setup. So I like to, like you just saw, get stuck in there, everything nice, straight, line, put my ass down to the fucking pad. So nothing's moving, just my quads.
Right, five more. Four, three, two, one. Bucket. 10 more. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
I got it.
Come on. Go!
Fucking bitch. Oh my god.
What
was that? 30? 32, you counted 10 when I was on 2. So that was 32.
I counted, yeah.
Like
what?
When I was at 2, you're like 10, 9, I'm like, fuck.
Whatever. I can't count, so.
We both can't count.
We have two other interns here.
Do the same way?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's go, let's go. Two. Let's go. Three. Make contract, contract, contract. Two. Up, 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 up.
Come on.
Four.
Go. Go, kick. Up, six, come on, seven. up, 8, up, 9, up, 10, up, come on, up, 12, up, 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 good.
Another important thing about having a trainer. They're always there for your safety.
That's right. I know she can do the whole stack. She's started depleted, she's depleted. She's going to show. You already know she can do that weight, so she's going to include it. Risk of her injuring herself. It's stupid.
So what do we have next?
That's what. Maybe next.
Yeah. How much weight?
Yeah, let's start with that.
Are we doing this one? The new one?
Yeah.
Yeah, so this machine, for some reason, whenever you're coming down, it's like super smooth and you're like, oh yeah, I got this. And for some reason, when you go up, it like gets a little bit like, it's stuck. You haven't fixed that yet, right?
No, we're poor, so. We're poor over here, so. We haven't fixed the bearings, we need new bearings, so I'm waiting for the guy to come in to replace them. But he's lazy as shit, so he hasn't come in like a week. But it feels like there's a band at the bottom, so.
So it makes it even harder.
Exactly.
So it's like, you know, you might as well just leave it like this. Maybe it won't work harder. They're like, oh, it's only this much weight, I can do this, and then they're dying. Like I was literally doing it the other day with no weight on it. I was like, passed out.
Alright, so these are my cues before I even do it. Look. I'm just getting more rest. So when I unhook it, I'm gonna pretend like I'm pushing this whole entire machine out that window. Okay? That's my main priority. As I come down, I'm gonna pretend like I'm meeting my ass with the back of my heels at the bottom, pretending like it's an accordion. Alright? So when I come down, I'm introducing my ass to my heels, and on the way up, I'm trying to contract it all the way through with my hamstrings and my quads to come back up. I usually cue a leg extension that I teach them on the leg extension with the cues I showed you earlier on the way up as well. So it makes the exercise a lot harder when you're concentrating on the cues more than just bouncing up and down with the inertia and the tempo and all the other bullshit. So we're gonna use this weight. I'm gonna show you how technical we do it, and then the following sets, we're just gonna go up and down, up and down. That's enough.
Okay, so
Charles Glass, like 4 years ago. I used to go train with him in LA. Here's a reverse hack squat, reverse squat on the hack squat machine. You can't really do this on the majority of the hack squats. He usually uses it on the Flex Fitness one because that's what they have in Gold's Gym Venice. So that was the purpose of this machine for me purchasing it. Because you can do this variation of a squat, the regular variation, the split squat, and you can also do a stiff legged dead. But for Stephanie, since we're focusing on the hamstrings for her more, she's gonna go into the reverse. It's like a sumo squat at the same time. You see how her feet are coming off. She's gonna point her toes just a little bit more wider. She can get into the pad. She's gonna put her forehead right in here and her shoulder blade. Her shoulders, she's gonna be right at the edge of the pad. She's gonna come up, close these in, watch her fingers. Squat down, open her knees. She's gonna drive her hips forward, squeeze with her glutes, and push up. One. Drive it up. Two. Three hips forward. Drive it up. There you go, six. Drive. 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 Nine. There you go. Three asses. It's four. Up. 11. Come on. 12. Give me three more. Drive. Two more. Drive. One more.
Come on. Go. Five. Six.
Come on. Three more. Let's go. Come on.
Fix yourself. You got at least four now. Come on. Up. Power. Back down right now. Power.
Go, 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 go.
You got more. Let's go. Back down. Power. That's 11. Keep it going. Keep it moving. Keep it moving. You want tighter glutes?
Drive.
You got to outwork these girls.
Come on. One more. Come on. One more.
Let's go.
Go.
Let's go.
Drive. One more. One more. Come on. Drive. Come on. Come on. Good.
That's the abchick. That's the abchick.
Y'all be prepared to learn how to really kill your glutes on the abductor machine. A lot of people make a mistake of using this machine for their thumbs. This is where they text. So listen up.
Okay, so as you can see, there's different feet positionings here, and there's handles. Over the years, when I would go to these different trainers and learn from them, everyone has like a different approach, and I combined all of their approaches and came up with my own. So one trainer would always leave something out that's sometimes beneficial to the exercise. Like I said over there on the leg extension, the setup is key. In my opinion, it's key, because I could go sitting here, my torso and everything is relaxed and it's just open. It looks like I'm doing the exercise, textbook form right, right?
Correct,
yeah, exactly. But if I do it and I set myself up perfectly, like this, pulling my ass down, pushing my back into the pad as hard as I can, and now I am progressively pushing out with my knees, the only thing that's being utilized is my abductors. Abductors. So, and I'm controlling on the way in as well. Instead of going like this, and then letting it come in, and then like that, that's bullshit. So if you want to make the most bang for your buck, put your ass down, and progressively push out. And once you reach that final point, continue to push, not hold, because they're two different things. If you continue to push out, it's a greater contraction than just holding it out. Now you're going to control it with that contraction on the way back in. And you know, don't power out of there, because then now you're using inertia. You want to control it back out, and it's a lot more demanding on the muscle. And it's not time under tension, because I'm not counting anything in my fucking head. It's utilizing the actual muscles to do the exercise for you. Not counting any seconds on the way in or on the way out. It's not time under tension. That's my first, oh my God, my ass. That was my first setup. My second one, I'm gonna go straight over here to the first peg. Now my back is gonna be off the pad, but I'm still pulling my ass down into the pad as well. So again, control on the way out. Holy shit, okay. Shoot it back in. Fuck. Yeah. Mm. And for the bouncing type of reps, I call those, or some other people call them reserve reps, where once you reach failure, then you can bounce it out, but it's still effective. For your last reps, once you reach failure. Now, I'm gonna go into my last one. My ass is back here, okay, my feet, same position. I'm just reaching for the bar, my ass is back here. Again, I'm progressively pushing out with my knees. Then you can join back in. See, I'm not bouncing, I'm controlling. So if I'm like one of these Instagram girls, I'm going like this. Like, you're not fucking using anything. So, like, I could do that for days. Oh my God. There's no bouncing involved. Just do 10, 10, and 10. See how she didn't explode out of there? She's progressively pushing, utilizing that muscle. Using that contraction to come back in as well. Instead of relaxing and then letting gravity take over. She's hitting failure. Now she can go ahead and just fucking pump them out. Go, go. Go. Five. It's still pretty reps. Come on. Good. She's gonna last one over here. Just reach. Stay right there. Lift your butt up. One. Control. Three. Two. Four. Five. Ready, pump them out. Go, go. Six. Go. Seven. Eight. Come on. Nine. Ten. Go. 11. Come on. 12. Keep going. 13. 14. One more. One more. 15. Good. We're gonna start with the second foot placement and then go to the first one and then.
Yeah. go seven. Oh. You got it, let's go.
Energy and like, I'm so
moving
now. on. Come on. Come on, all the way up. One more.
This one, this.
Oh my God. Go. Ah, it burns. Oh my God.
What's up, girl? Squeeze.
It's all you. It's all you. All you.
And how is that?
Hi. I think, I don't know.
Six. Seven. One more, and then you get up with it. Up, grab it. Three.
Use your hips.
Four. Come on.
There you go.
Five. Come on. Six. Go. Seven. One more. Up.
Hips.
There you go. See it off? One. Come on. Go. Come on.
Drive.
Two. One.
Up.
Three.
Up.
Go. Four. Five.
Go.
Six. Roll them out. Fast. Come on. Seven. Come on. Eight. Come on. Nine. Come on. 10. 11, come on, 12, go, 13, 14, one more up, 15, done.
Yay.
Hips. There you go. Go. 7, 8, hips, 8, there you go, 7, go, all the way up, 6, hips, 5, let's go, 4, you, let's go, 3, all the way up, 2 more, let's go, you got it. Last one, use your hips. Hips. Racket. Okay, let's go.
Can I get more in the middle? Push harder. Give me one. Over here. Did 30 minutes of that, and I did 15 minutes of cardio stairs, and now I have to go finish up my last 15 minutes. So grind don't stop, we keep on going, and we reach those goals no matter what happens. So if you guys like this content, if you guys like these videos, if you guys want to see more of me now that I'm flying back to California, please tell PJ and go and bother him and tell him Stephanie needs to be more on YouTube for Blackstone. We want to see more of Stephanie, and I'll produce. So, till then, thank you guys for watching. This is Iron University. I'm Stephanie Sequeira, the Ab Chick. This is Blackstone Labs, and peace out, bye.